The IEP asked experts, what issues the US administration should focus on until the end of this year? Here's what they said.
One thing would be useful to take some steps to ease tensions with Russia. I think that given the fact that Russia is a nuclear power, it's close to Europe. I mean, it is partially in Europe. I think the implications of growing tensions between US and Russia could be significant. I think that's one thing that I am a little disappointed.
I think the two major issues which Mr. Biden must confront are the relations with China and the relations with Russia. For us in Europe, immediately, of course, the relations with Russia are very important, and he was not very skillful in preparing a possibility to come to terms with Russia's President Putin.
As I said, for me, global heating is an unprecedented global public policy challenge. COP26 in Glasgow in December will show that the changes that are required to limit warming will actually be acted upon.
There is so much to do for President Biden for the rest of this year. But to my mind, what is really important is to think about arms control and non-proliferation. We have the review conference coming up for the non-proliferation treaty. We have the first meeting of the states' parties of the Treaty on the Prohibition of Nuclear Weapons. And while I've mentioned he has already extended New START, he is talking about JCPOA, it is not clear to me what is actually the strategy of the United States in arms control and non-proliferation. What does America really want?
As the U.S. slowly begins to exit the COVID-19 pandemic through the efforts of mass vaccinations, as well as a rapid economic recovery, it's important that it starts to turn its attention towards supporting the rest of the international community, particularly through initiatives such as COVAX. The Biden administration has already promised $4 billion in funding for COVAX, but it seems like the most important choke point going forward will be supply of vaccinations rather than funding.
So the revival of the JCPOA by the end of the year would be the biggest success when it comes to multilateralism.
Now they are facing the challenge to start negotiations with the Russians on reductions of nuclear weapons, and this should be very comprehensive. It would be rather a deflection if they would concentrate on a single use, a doctrinal issue, as long as it is not supported by arms reduction.
That the United States should engage more pragmatically with Russia in view of the current situation, where there is common ground, where it's common interest, rather than to launch a Cold War type of containment and confrontation policy.
An issue I think the US should be focusing on until the end of the year is still is the Middle East. We know that since many years, and that already started at the Obama times, that the US is not so much interested anymore in Middle Eastern politics. But even though in the election campaign, Mr. Biden was talking positive of the so-called Abraham Accords, which are those normalization treaties between Israel and some Arab countries, namely Morocco, Sudan, Bahrain, and the Emirates.
I think there's ambitious plans to focus on infrastructure, broadly understood, not just physical infrastructure, but digital infrastructure, education, skills. And I believe that's critical for the future of America. The U.S. has fallen behind, particularly behind China, in many of these dimensions. Biden also seems aware that it's important to do something here. We'll see if Congress goes along or not.
You know, basically, the major issue that Biden needs to do is to win the 2022 midterm elections. That's key. Otherwise, you know, we're nowhere. And Trump will be back.